In this tutorial, I'll show you how to morph a curve into another one. Using geometry nodes in Blender, you can make morphing animation with any curves, like numbers, alphabets, or my language character, Hangul. If you press the like button or subscribe to my channel, it's gonna definitely help me keep on creating Blender tutorials. Let's get this tutorial started. First, I'm going to show you the core idea of this tutorial, which is implemented by a sample curve node. The sample curve node enables a curve to use another curve's information like position, normal, tangent, or any value available. In this example, a curve circle, as an original curve, is going to use the position data from a star curve, as a target curve. And with mix node, we can control the mix between the original curve and the target curve. Don't forget to connect the factor of spline parameter node, which makes mapping between points on each curve having same factor. And I recommend to use resample curve node, to make each curve have same number of points. From now on, we're gonna build the actual node configuration. First, we need to prepare a list of number curves which is gonna be used as an input source for the node configuration. You can draw curves and edit control points on the curve, to make better shape. I recommend that the curve should not be cyclic in order to create a smoother morphing animation. If your curve happens to be cyclic after drawing, you can toggle cyclic, which can be found on the right-click menu, in edit mode. Or, just redraw it. Let's make a new collection and add the curve into the collection. It is important that all the curves are located in the same collection, if you want a morphing animation among the specific group of curves. Before making numbers to 9, I'm gonna show you how to use this collection in the geometry nodes. You can drag and drop the collection like this. Instead of using collection info itself directly, we're gonna use an instance on points node. It is because, with this node we can choose one object from the collection. By clicking the pick instance mode and plugging the instance index value into the node, you can select the object at the index, within the collection. As you can see, the input index are automatically calculated with the size of the collection by module operation, as a result, to make cycle. Because the instance on points node return outputs as a type of instance, we have to apply the realize instances node to use the outputs as a type of curve. We can make the output curves with same number of points by applying resample curve node. It's time to make morphing animation, using scene time node. The fraction math node is the key node for morphing animation, because it controls the mix factor. let's make a little pause between change using float curve node, because the continuous change looks unnatural. Looks better. Let's add number curves from 4 to 9. In this tutorial, I recommend one stroke drawing for a single curve. Here is the example of one stroke drawing for number 4. Wow, looks good. Wait. The morph from 7 to 8 can be made simpler. By switching direction of a curve, we can make more natural morphing between two number curves. We can make a custom remesh modifier and geometry nodes, with mesh to volume node, and volume to mesh node. Thank you. let's make random change of index using random value node. Good, we made it. Geometry nodes are just builded up finally. Now, we can make different morphing animations by applying other collections like alphabet, Hangul, or your language characters. I prepared collections of alphabet, Hangul in advance. If you would like to use these collections, you can download the project file in Blender format, which will be uploaded on my Gumroad after this video is published on YouTube. All you have to do is just switching collections. This is the end of this video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful and thank you for watching, and if you'd like to help support this channel, then some great ways to do that are by subscribing my channel or checking out my Gumroad store. I'll have the Gumroad link in the description. I hope you found this helpful again. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys very soon, later.